Stand up. You have it in your Bibles? It's going to also be on the screen in two translations. Remember that there's only one interpretation. But I often study from 17 translations. Amen. And Sister Bowler has provided for us that even in our Bible reading, if you've got the phone app or the iPad app or the computer app, is that you can study your daily Bible reading from either Holman or KJV, King James Version. Amen. Don't get so holy where you think that the only translation is King James Version. Because I'll tell you that it was given to Shakespeare in the 16th century. Amen. We look for the closest to how it was said when it was said. That's it. Well, let's go home. Do you have John?
Yes, sir.
Chapter
9.
Well, since Reverend Monique is here, let's take John 8, 59.
Yes, sir.
If you got your Bibles, it should be easy for you just got to move up.
Yes, sir.
Because there's a very interesting verse that precedes John 9. Verses 8, that is 59 of chapter 8. Yes. Let me see what I read here.
All right.
It says, then they took up stones. And does the next few words say to cast? Have we got a witness? Could you help with the other two? Didn't they know this was Jesus? It was okay. You can add him, and then what else? Now wait a minute. He could call them angels. He could say, "Okay, I'm done with them." He could have done whatever he needed to do on his 100% divine. But look and see what he did. What did he do? He did? Oh, somebody simplistically, and if you were plural, which means childish, you would say that he was a coward. If somebody throws a bit, that proves to you that he really was Jesus. Sometimes you got to stop being a bad person.
Yes, sir.
You see how my vocabulary has changed? Yeah. this man or his parents that he was blind. There had to be a relationship, a correlation between the child being blind and the parents' sin. And what did the Lord say? And Jesus answered, neither had this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be manifest in him.
Amen.
Two more verses, and then you can sit down or you can stand with me. I must work the works of him that sent me while it's day.
Yeah.
The night coming when no man can work. Fifth verse, let's read it all together. Is that give him a piece of gas.
Are you a fan? Have a government. It's a sister, Mother McAllister talks to my wife almost every day. And so she said, Sister White, I don't know whether you're going to tell the pastor this, but that was a lady who came to church, and she said, after the pastor asked the question, who likes sin? Ever got a witness?
Yeah.
And nobody raised their hand except one individual over in the corner. Ever got a witness? Who was probably half asleep when he heard the question. Ever got a witness? You know what she said? I do. He said, sister, do you not sin? And she said, oh no, I thought you said gin.
Get
about it. Don't worry about it. Because I'm with you. Can I tell you what it's about to say?
Yes.
Say it. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any idea why Jesus was under attack? The 8th chapter, the first to the 11th verse, is going to give you a clue. Whenever you start talking about either sex or any lust of the fleshly desires,
right.
People are going to look at you and say that you are not normal. Have I got rid of this? Even though God made us to the pleasures of sexual relationships, amen? People will start to say, huh, I knew you were after. I would.